In this lesson, we will learn how to manage security groups and security rules. Under the network menu, we choose security groups. Security groups are actually rules that allow network traffic out of our virtual machines and in our virtual machines. There is one default security group which is created for every user of the cloud service. This default security group contains very strict rules. All network traffic is disallowed unless one of the four rules displayed are applied. The first two rules concern traffic that is outgoing from our virtual machine. These two rules means that any traffic that is IP version 4 or IP version 6 is allowed towards any other machine using any protocol and any port range. That means that if the traffic originates from our machines and is directed to the internet, then it is allowed. The same holds true for the responses to this traffic. So our virtual machines can by default access the internet, download a web page, or download some updates for the operating system. The other two rules concern the incoming traffic. The third and the fourth rules mean that incoming traffic is allowed for IPv4 or IPv6 only if it comes from a virtual machine that is in the same security group as this machine. That means that no other machine from the internet can access our virtual machine. Only the machines that we create in our personal space and that we apply the default security group to them can connect to our machine. As already said, the rules for the network traffic are very strict. If we want to gain access to our virtual machine, we have to relax these rules and allow some more traffic towards our machine. If we want to access our machine using the SSH protocol, we have to allow it. So we click on Add Rule in order to add a rule for the SSH protocol. Fortunately, there are some templates, let's say, for various well-known services that make it easy to add specific rules to our security group. So in the rule, we click. As we can see, there are already rules for allowing specific services. There is a rule for allowing the SSH service. We click SSH on the rule. Then we have to define from which IP addresses we will allow SSH traffic coming into our virtual machine. If we want to access our virtual machine using the SSH protocol from any other place in the internet, we can leave this address as it stands. Otherwise, we can add specific IP addresses that are allowed to connect to our virtual machine. I will not change the defaults and I will click Add. Now a new rule is applied that says that any incoming traffic that is of the SSH protocol is also allowed. If we want to see when our virtual machine is alive and we wish to use the ping command to send a small package to our machine and get back a reply, we must add another rule for this protocol. The protocol that the ping command uses is the ICMP protocol. Then we can add a rule named all ICMP as previously. We click Add. Now this network traffic is also allowed. Any other machine in the internet is allowed to ping our machine and get back a small package that says that our machine is alive. is connected and it is up and running. If we want to install a web server in our machine and make it accessible from the rest of the internet, we will add yet another rule. Again, the same process. We choose HTTP from the rule, from the already prepared rules, and click Add. Usually, access to web servers is done either with the HTTP protocol or the more secure HTTPS protocol. Therefore, we must add another rule for the HTTPS protocol. We choose it, click Add, and then we have another two rules that allow any other machine in the internet to contact our web server if it is installed in our machine and request web pages from our virtual machines using the HTTP or HTTPS protocol. This way we can manage the rules that are applied to our virtual machines. Any traffic that is not explicitly allowed by these rules is disallowed. When using these security groups and rules, be very careful and do not allow traffic that is not intended for your machine. If you wish, you can create different security groups for different machines. By clicking the Create Security Group button, you can give a name to a new security group and then add different rules to this group and apply that group to different virtual machines.